Welcome back, guys. Chris here, and in this video, I'm bringing you the August 2025 edition of NetSuite News. I only have a few things to talk to you about, but they're major subjects, so let's get straight into it. Starting off with the NetSuite certifications. Oracle NetSuite has done a revamp, if you will, on their certifications. The same certifications still exist. So you have Suite Foundation, the Administrators, ERP Consultant, Financial User, Suite Analytics, as well as the three developer certifications. Those all still exist, but they've repackaged and represented how you deal with those certifications. So before, you could literally just in Google type in NetSuite certification. It would bring you to the NetSuite page. There's a whole section on certifications. It has all of the different certifications, and on each one, you can click on it and you have access to the study guide for them, the practice exams, and right there, there would be a button so that you can sign up for the actual exams. And then it takes you to another website, you log in, and then you actually pay for those exams. Instead of doing it that way, which was relatively simple, it was easy to find, easy to navigate through, they've now taken that. As of just a month ago, they've taken it off of the NetSuite site. So there's still a NetSuite site on certifications, but just gives you some basic information. To actually access these things, you now need to go into Oracle's MyLearn, which is actually a different site, different logon and everything. And you have to log in there. Now you can do it for free, although there's a lot of things on MyLearn that do cost money. You can get initial access for free. And once you're in there, the first thing to take note is, just from what I've noticed in dealing with MyLearn, it's easy to go onto MyLearn and be in an Oracle mode. So everything you're gonna see is Oracle products and Oracle certifications. You have to actually go up to the top left and there's a little globe. If you click on that, you can switch it to NetSuite if it's not already set as that. Once you're on NetSuite, you'll start to see some of the NetSuite certifications. You click on the one you want, and within there, they're gonna have some basic courses. They have paid courses that you can access. They're extremely long. They're about 40 hours long. So you can pay for those if you want the LCS kind of MyLearn version of the, let's say, Suite Foundation training. And one of the modules that you'll see there is a practice exam. You don't have to pay for it, but you have to go on through MyLearn to access it. You click on that and then you have the ability to download it. One additional update in terms of the examination is that it used to cost for Suite Foundation $250. And there were a couple, like Suite Analytics and Financial User was only $150, but the major certifications were all $250. So they've now recategorized it where you have Suite Analytics, Financial User, and Suite Foundation is all considered in the lower level of certifications as opposed to their professional certs. And all of those are now priced at $125. So they used to be either $250 or $150, and those have moved down now to $125. So that's good news for people that are trying to get that entry level certification. They've also come out with a little bit of additional information on the certifications themselves. So for example, Suite Foundation, they've never openly stated what is the passing standard for that exam. And now they've openly stated that it is 55% questions correct to be able to pass that exam. I initially had thought it was a little bit higher than that, but evidently it's just 55%, unless they changed their grading standard just in the last month, which I highly doubt. And more to that point, they actually came out with a new version of the sample test. This is something I get asked about all the time. How do I get the most up-to-date version? People are always concerned that every year, the exam is gonna be changing dramatically, both in terms of the final exam and the sample test. So just to give you a concept of that, because I've told this to people through the years, but just to add further proof to it, if you take the July 2025 sample test that just came out and you compare it to, which I did, the sample test that was issued in 2023, if you do a back-to-back comparison of those, they have identical questions. The questions are the same, the answers are the same, everything is the same between those two. They have some study guide information that's different, but the sample tests are identical. And I promise you, when it comes to the final exams, if they're not identical over the last year or two, they're certainly very, very similar. I've been able to take a look at some of the tests that occurred even 5 or 6 years ago, and then you compare it to today, they will add additional questions every now and again, just a few questions. And then every now and again, they'll take off questions that are related to modules or tools that they've deprecated. But other than that, they have the test and they are not putting any additional time or energy into this thing. The last thing I want to talk to you about is the 2025.2 release notes that NetSuite just came out with. If you aren't already aware of it, NetSuite has two releases every single year where they roll it out for all of their different clients and customers. And this is the second one, which is going to be rolling out over the next 3 months, basically leading into Suite World. So there are a lot of things to talk about regarding the release notes. And if I went into great detail, honestly, I could go on for hours because we're talking over 100 different fixes, bug tweaks, enhancements, new tools, et cetera, et cetera. So there's a lot of different things to talk about. I'm not gonna obviously discuss all of those things in this particular video. I'm gonna focus on some of the major areas that I feel are relevant to comment on. And overall, in relation to this release, my general thoughts or comments on it is that one, there's nothing in this release that, even if minor, I would say impacts the vast majority of NetSuite users. Most of the tools, tweaks, enhancements are all in relation to specific modules or tools. And even amongst those, there's nothing that's groundbreaking in any particular area. And there's nothing necessarily wrong with that. It's pretty common for any product or software or game or anything to come out with releases that fix problems in the system, add a few relatively minor enhancements, and then you move forward. So first off, there are features, quite a few features that are coming in relation to MRP and inventory management. So again, these are not groundbreaking features, but you have a few different things such as there's now a scheduled save search that you can easily set up that's going to look at your supply plan definitions, which are like the beating heart of your MRP setup, and check to see if any of them are not executing properly. In other words, the fact that your MRP system is not working the way it should, and it will send you or email you an alert if that MRP setup is not functioning correctly. So that's definitely good to know. Again, it's not imperative. It's not life-changing to have it, but it's certainly a nice additional feature. And there's a few different things like that, all tying into MRP and inventory management. The next major category, again, still in line with inventory management, but specifically with WMS, they've added a number of different enhancements for WMS. And just to comment on that specifically, I'll probably come out with a full course or at least a mini course on WMS in the next month or two, because it's an area that's gaining in popularity. And just to give a little bit of a time track on WMS, if you go back 5 or 6 years ago, it was definitely not a strong product. It had many flaws and it was really just kind of left by the wayside and most people just ignored it. So I'll give a whole history probably in other videos on the subject of WMS, but the fact of the matter is they kind of clued in 5 or 6 years ago that they really need to turn things around with WMS. So every release over the last several years, they've been coming out with just more and more enhancements for that product, both influencing WMS as well as some of the sub-modules that come under WMS like Ship Central. And it's gone to the point where I would say that WMS is really getting to where it's actually useful for quite a few clients, especially if they have very specific and I would say more limited requirements. WMS might be a great option for them. And it's getting closer and closer to being really a competitor to some of the other big competitors in the environment, like RFSmart is a major one. Moving on from that, there was a number of features added to Suite Tax. And this is another area where NetSuite has really been a little bit on the back foot for a number of years, where other alternatives like Avalara that have dominated in the area of taxes, they're starting to get their own product with Suite Tax to be a comparable, not that it can do all the things that some of these competitors can do, but at least can function and provide enough features and flexibility for the average client that doesn't need super advanced tax solutions, something that can compete and can facilitate their requirements. So for example, when it came to Suite Tax in this release, they're adding features like breaking things down by state, also known as tax nexus, providing some additional flexibility within states, and also looking at different time ranges and for each state in that time range, which taxes would be relevant, exemptions, things like that. So these are great features to add on to a function that most companies have some need for. On from that, there's another feature that I think is particularly cool for SaaS-based industries or companies. So if they're selling software as a service and that is their bread and butter, they've come out with a SaaS 360 dashboard. So this is a dashboard you could otherwise create going through a consulting agency and having them make that for you custom. Now NetSuite is just rolling it out as a matter of fact. So any customer in that SaaS ecosystem can have this dashboard that they pull up. It includes metrics on churn rate and clients and how they break down in terms of their products and profitability margins and all of these things baked into one very helpful dashboard. So features like that are always good to see, where they're just adding in more functionality, something that's easy to access. And even if it's just for a few clients, there are going to be clients that need for that SaaS industry. And it's a great thing to just pick up off the shelf. Addition to that, we have another, I think it was two roles that have additionally been rolled out. One in particular is the site operator role. So this is just another example of the dozens and dozens of template roles that come with NetSuite. They now have a specific one that instead of having to go to a more comprehensive project manager role and start stripping away some of the roles and permissions, you can grab this site operator. It has limited functionality and permissions, but it just kind of gives them exactly what they need without having them go into some other aspects of the system that you wouldn't want them messing around in. So again, it's not groundbreaking, but it's something that's nice to have. It generally will save time more for the consultants that would initially be going in and setting up all of these different roles and permissions. So those are some of the major categories that I noted, primarily the ones that I thought were particularly improvement and just kind of interesting to talk about. But then of course we come to the last area, which is AI, the thing that NetSuite talks about endlessly for the last several years. And I've commented in many videos that I've made up until this point, the fact of the matter is there's really only a handful of NetSuite products that have any kind of AI capabilities. And for the most part, those capabilities are limited and in some cases just not useful, or they're not functioning enough to make them widely accessible for most clients. And if you have any question about that, you can watch my other, I have an AI tools video where I go in quite a bit of detail on this subject. So first off, we have something I talked about in my last NetSuite News video, which is an improvement to the text enhance feature, which basically allows a translation element. So you can go in, you can have it populate text, and then you could translate that to a different language. And in general, I would say that's a useful add-on. It's definitely nice to have. I would still argue that for a lot of companies that are heavily reliant on a multilingual aspect, they often rely on other translation software because they don't just need it on a few text-enhanced boxes, they need it for their company in general. And so they have facilities and software to accommodate for that. So adding in a translation element for a lot of companies, it's not gonna end up being that helpful, but again, it's nice to have. So fine, they added that in. There was a second addition to Text Enhance, which is particular for suite people, where they basically allow these requisition forms. Like if you're trying to put out a form to get new hires, you can use Text Enhance to populate that form and save yourself time in having to write out this whole requisition hiring form. The reality of that is that, first off, Suite People is one of the least popular and most criticized modules that NetSuite has, from my experience. So it's for a feature that is very unpopular and often not sought after. And then it is a very specific, it's only with Text Enhance, for this one form that you can populate some information and save yourself time. And yet at the same time, you could easily use any other AI tool like ChatGPT, DeepSeek, Gemini, Copilot, Grok, whatever you want, to do the exact same thing. Right in a different browser and then copy and paste it into your form. It just, you have to ask yourself, in the very niche instance where it's a company using Suite People where they do want to do that thing, but they don't want to do it on another browser, I guess that's going to save you a few seconds time. I just don't see it being a practical, a broadly practical or efficient time-saving tool. So that was one of their big releases regarding AI. Now they did point out a number of other AI enhancements or tools that they're releasing, but I noticed that a handful of them, really the majority that I saw of these AI tools that are incorporating in the NetSuite products, were actually all related to either planning and budgeting or analytics warehouse. Now, it's great to say that we're adding tools, and I'm not even gonna comment on whether those AI additions and enhancements are good or bad for those products. What I will say is, despite all the marketing, the fact of the matter is, Analytics Warehouse and Planning and Budgeting are not NetSuite products. Those are Oracle products. Oracle acquired NetSuite. So NetSuite is a product of Oracle, and Planning and Budgeting and Analytics Warehouse and all of these other things, OpenAir, which is now called Suite Projects Pro, these are Oracle products. You purchase them separately. It's a separate logon, a separate structure, architecture. It's just a totally different thing. So to come out in a NetSuite release and say these other Oracle products are getting these AI enhancements, it sounds nice, but the reality of it is for the majority of clients that are just dealing with NetSuite and they're not also paying for a totally separate product that's going to integrate onto NetSuite, why are we talking about additions to those products' AIs? Anyways, that's my rant in relation to the new release. And again, overall, I do think it is a perfectly decent release. There's a lot of nice enhancements that are coming out with that, additions, tools, and there's a whole list of bugs and annoying problems that you could run into in specific situations that they've resolved. So that's all great. I just get a little bit exhausted on the subject of AI and the lack thereof. And then the last point I'm going to bring up before wrapping up this video, I generally do a little segment on super training highlights. And in this video, I want to highlight the individual complete package. I get a lot of emails on this. So just to be clear, yes, it does include all the NetSuite courses that I currently have, which at this exact moment is 18 courses. And I come out with new courses all the time. So like I said earlier in this video, I'll shortly be coming out with a WMS mini course. I'll be doing a data migration course in terms of like how to move on to NetSuite for the first time. I'll probably be coming out with an intermediate slash advanced accounting course in the near future. So all these things are coming down the pipeline. If you want access to not only the existing courses, but also those new courses, you'd want to get a subscription to my individual complete package. And for those people that are looking to make a profession in NetSuite and don't have access to an actual demo account or sandbox environment, I only have a handful of them as access, so it's not like I can widely give them out to everyone that signs up for that package. But if you do have a dire need for a demo account, and I know they're hard to come by, you can reach out to me by email, and if I have enough on hand, I can maybe set you up with one. So you can always reach out to me, and we'll see if we can help you out. And with all of that in mind, if you found this video helpful, please hit that like button. Subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. I'll be coming out with more content, especially on the subject of Suite World, which is coming up soon. And that's all coming down the pipeline in addition to my courses and normal tutorials, etc. So if you want any of that, please subscribe. And with all of that in mind, I hope to see you in the next video.